Well, guys, there is a lot going on today. The chairman of the Joint Chiefs of Staff shot back at Republicans like Matt Gaetz, who have accused the military of being too woke. Jared Kushner and Ivanka Trump are supposedly distancing themselves from the former president. And best of all, Rudy Giuliani is back in the news after his New York law license was suspended. For more on this, it's time for a closer look. The modern Republican Party doesn't have a discernible ideology or a set of policy goals aside from its hostility to democracy. So it needs to keep ginning up fake panics to keep their voters angry and mobilized. That's why they've spent most of Joe Biden's presidency so far cycling from one made-up culture war boogeyman to the next. Like when they said the left wanted to ban Dr. Seuss or Mr. Potato Head or that Biden was going to outlaw hamburgers. You think Joe Biden would outlaw hamburgers? I mean, look at the man. He's the grandpa at the barbecue who keeps trying to sneak his grandkids a hot dog over the objections of their vegan parents. Hey, if your mom sees it, we'll tell her it's a brown carrot. All right, now throw that soybean in the garbage. I'll let you drive my stingray. And now their latest astroturfed moral panic is over something called critical race theory, a field of academic study which examines the structural roots of American racism and the ways in which it's embedded in our laws and institutions. Republicans, however, are just using it as a catch-all to gin up fake outrage over discussion of systemic racism in schools.
Critical race theory is the study of structural racism embedded in legal systems and policies that are often taught in graduate school. But conservatives are using it as a pretext to ban the teaching of slavery and other anti-racist education in public schools across America. Critical race theory is usually taught at the college level or higher. It's 40 years plus old, right? It's been talked around grad schools for some time. How did Republicans bring this fight to elementary schools?
Well, first of all, if you ask somebody running an elementary school, for example, if they're teaching critical race theory, they will say, absolutely not, we don't know what you're talking about.
Yeah, exactly. If anything, our textbooks tend to sanitize our history. And why do you want to make educators' lives more difficult by berating them about a thing they're not doing anyway? Teachers already have such a tough job. If I were a teacher, I'd be so exhausted most of the time, I'd just make my kids watch Amadeus on Laserdisc every day. Oh, come on, Mr. Myers, I'd rather get an F than watch this movie again. Oh, you'll get an F, all right. An F. Murray Abraham, who ironically gives an A-plus performance. Now, shh, I'm going to put my head down. In reality, school curricula are not nearly comprehensive enough when it comes to teaching children about the history of systemic racism in this country. The first time a lot of people heard about the Tulsa massacre was in Watchmen. And as a rule, it's not great when you learn more from HBO than from your school. I mean, imagine having Samantha as your health teacher. My first rule of safe sex, make sure you have a padded headboard. And it's not just the Tulsa massacre. There's also the Southern Counter-Revolution against Reconstruction after the Civil War and the campaign of white supremacist terror during what was called the Southern Redemption, which was aimed at undoing the gains of emancipation and racial equality after the war, or the mob riot in Wilmington, North Carolina in 1898 that overthrew a legitimately elected biracial government, among many other things. Most history textbooks either leave that stuff out or it sanitizes it. They just go from the Civil War to the Great Depression with a chapter in between that says, your search returned no results and a shrug emoji. Republicans freak out at any attempt to teach our children the actual history of systemic racism and its structural roots in our institution. And they're using critical race theory as a catch-all. Most of them don't even know what it is and can't define it. Instead, they just lie about it like Ted Cruz.
Critical race theory says every white person is a racist. Critical race theory says America is fundamentally racist and irredeemably racist. Critical race theory seeks to turn us against each other, and if someone has a different color skin, seeks to make us hate that person.
Okay, Salieri. All right, well, that means you guys aren't watching it. There's a reason we show it every day. It does not say that, Ted Cruz, but good luck at your audition for Bigfoot's nephew. You don't just get to make up your own definitions for terms that already have definitions. It's like if I'm hanging out with some Gen Zers and I say, hey, you guys want to stand some weed? This bud ships. And they're like, that's not what any of those words mean. And I say, oh, yeah, actually, oh, it is. Because they have multiple definitions. And then I run home and I log on to Urban Dictionary and write an entry for Stan that says to smoke weed. And then I get banned from Urban Dictionary for submitting false information. I mean, that didn't happen. But if it did, I still maintain I was right, Tyler. Also, Ted, it might be easier to read about critical race theory if you took off the sunglasses. I mean, look at this dude. He looks like he got fired from the Men in Black for stealing ink cartridges from the printer. In reality, critical race theory says the opposite of what Cruz claimed. And if you want a pretty good distillation of the pushback to this right-wing nonsense, and I can't believe I'm about to say this, just listen to the chairman of the Joint Chiefs, General Mark Milley, at a House hearing yesterday.
I do think it's important, actually, for those of us in uniform to be open-minded and be widely read. And the United States Military Academy is a university. And it is important that we train and we understand. And I want to understand white rage, and I'm white, and I want to understand it. So what is it that caused thousands of people to assault this building and try to overturn the Constitution of the United States of America? What caused that? I want to find that out. I want to maintain an open mind here, and I do want to analyze it. It's important that we understand that, because our soldiers, sailors, airmen, Marines, and Guardians, they come from the American people. So it is important that the leaders, now and in the future, do understand it. So what is wrong with understanding, having some situational understanding about the country for which we are here to defend? And I personally find it offensive that we are accusing the United States military, our general officers, our commissioned, non-commissioned officers, of being, quote, woke or something else because we're studying some theories that are out there.
Damn. Of course, the best part of that clip is Matt Gaetz' face. He looks like he just tried to fit his square head into a round hole. The GOP used to accuse anyone who opposed their wars of not supporting the troops, and now they're accusing the troops of being too woke. Soon they're gonna start accusing SEAL Team 6 of committing voter fraud.
There's a lot to be suspicious about to begin with. There are more than six of them, and not one of them is an actual SEAL. I haven't been this disappointed since I went to Soldier Field and realized they weren't real dabbers.
But this is what Republicans have become during the Biden era. They're trying to manufacture a moral panic about critical race theory and passing a barrage of voter suppression laws to help them overturn elections. When you put it all together, it portends something very bad if Republicans ever get back into power. And look, the Biden presidency can feel deceptively calm at times, especially compared to the Trump era. There are no 3M Twitter screeds, indictments, chopper rants, Oval Office tantrums, or insane news alerts on your phone at 7 a.m. that say something like, President eats a golf ball covered in Sudafed to cure coronavirus, vomits all over Pence 5 minutes later.
It is the honor of my lifetime to get barfed on by you, sir. Go towel yourself off, come back, and I'll try to take another one.
Unlike Trump, who used to make a big, blustery statement next to a whirring helicopter blade, Biden does the opposite. He sometimes goes on long tangents about how complex the issues are and makes clear they can't be summed up with one simple, eye-catching headline.
When you run a country that does not abide by international norms, and yet you need those international norms to be somehow managed so that you can participate in the benefits that flow from them, it hurts you. That's not a satisfying answer. Biden said he'd invade Russia. You know, it's not, you know. By the way, that was a joke. That's not true.
You know, a summit with Vladimir Putin's not the best time to workshop your jokes. It's like your doctor leaning over right after surgery and saying, good news, we successfully sewed up your butt. That's a joke. We took out your spleen and then we sewed up your butt. I'm kidding. That's not true. We just did the spleen thing. This was supposed to be a triple bypass. Bypass these nuts! Wait, what was it supposed to be? So on the surface, the Biden era seems much calmer, but beneath that surface, there is a brewing crisis that's very much threatening our democracy. And we need to pay attention. Virtually the entirety of the Republican Party has pledged their loyalty to a disgraced former president who keeps lying about the legitimacy of our elections, and GOP voters believe him. More than half of Republicans have said in recent polls that Biden won because of fraud, and that election audits would reverse the outcome. Republicans like Ted Cruz and Lindsey Graham keep saying over and over that Trump is the leader of their party. And look, I don't want to talk about Trump. They do. Nothing would make me happier than if the Republican Party universally rejected the cult and ideology of Trumpism, and Trump himself jetted off into the sun, never to be heard from again. So I don't miss Donald Trump, but I will admit, I do occasionally miss some of the secondary characters in his orbit. You know, the whimsical goofballs who, with each passing day, fade further from the front pages. And, you know, I get sad thinking that I might never hear from them. Oh, hold on, wait a second. Is that our recently installed Rudy Giuliani news alert siren?
Breaking news just moments ago. Rudy Giuliani has been suspended from practicing law in New York State.
Today, a panel of judges came forward with their decision in a 33-page opinion. They say, in part, we conclude that there is uncontroverted evidence that respondent, that being Giuliani, communicated demonstrably false and misleading statements to the courts, lawmakers, and the public at large in his capacity as lawyer for former President Donald J. Trump.
I mean, I'm just shocked to find out Rudy had a law license. I bet Rudy is, too. I thought that with my Quiznos card. I'm one hole punch away from a free thumb. So Rudy can't practice law in New York anymore. Not that he really was before. I mean, I imagine the only reason to procure Rudy's legal services would be to have a lawyer who's guiltier than you are. Your Honor, sure, I robbed a liquor store, but wouldn't you rather send this guy to jail? I just hope when they took his law license, they showed up to his apartment to give him the news in person. And, you know, when they did that, I'm just, you know, spitballing here. You know, maybe there was a nosy neighbor across the hall in a Yankees hat eating bagel. Are you guys taking Rudy's law license away? That's good because, you know, the other day he asked me to hide his Cuban cigars in my closet. And, you know, when I opened the box to peek, it turns out they were just Vienna sausages. Anyway, can you believe they're not letting Garrett Cole use the sticky stuff? Sadly, you know, there are only so many characters, secondary Trump characters out there. And, you know, with every passing day, they're fading into oblivion. I mean, once Rudy Giuliani goes away, it's not like there's another Giuliani out there also doing dumb stuff. Oh, no! Oh, I can't believe it. Is that our newly installed Andrew Giuliani News Alert car horn? Basically a siren, but even dumber.
Hi, my fellow Americans. Today it's my fellow Americans, not just my fellow New Yorkers. As you may have heard recently, a few minutes ago, my father's law license was suspended. I am infuriated by all of this, and any American that believes in an independent justice system, this is going after one of President Trump's closest allies. That's exactly what this is. And any American that doesn't believe that, they are just biased. This is unacceptable, and I stand by my father. He did everything ultimately by the book, and the fact that there would be this politicization in our Justice Department is disgusting. Thank you for listening. Stay tuned. I'll have more statements later in the day.
Thank you for listening. And if you're wondering where the rest of my body is, the state of New York took that away too. Oh my God, seriously, man. Next time, could you get someone your height to hold the camera? Do you film this from an iPhone propped up on a regulation basketball hoop? This looks like a GoPro video from the point of view of a teenager playing keep away with their 8-year-old brother. Come on, guys, let me have the ball. This is unacceptable. I mean, why can't these guys frame a shot? They look like me during our first quarantine show. I'm not saying I'm pale, but I look like I'm doing a Jared Kushner makeup tutorial. Threw one in for you, Sal. I'll tell you this. The point is, I miss Rudy a little, but Donald Trump, not at all. The GOP are the ones who keep saying over and over that Donald Trump is the leader of their party. They're the ones who have devoted themselves to the ideology and cult of Trumpism and embraced Trump's big lie that the 2020 election was stolen, a lie Trump has been repeating as recently as this week.
There's a portion of the MAGA crowd, you know the deal, they're never going to forgive the vice president for not kicking those certain disputed election results back to state legislatures. What's your take on Mike Pence and how what's the relationship like?
Well, I've always liked Mike, and I'm very disappointed that he didn't send it back to the legislatures. I was disappointed that he didn't send it back. I felt he had the right to send it back, and he should have sent it back. And I think you would have found that you might very well have a different president right now had he sent him back.
First of all, you can't just send it back. We're talking about electoral votes, not an omelet at Mar-a-Lago. Yeah, there's just like a ton of eggshell in here, and could the chef peel and chop the onion? Second, I'll never get tired of pointing out that Mike Pence publicly debased himself in service of Trump, thinking it would be his ticket to the presidency, and it ended with Trump all over him. Pence is like that dude at the end of the Twilight Zone who's finally left alone with all his books and then his glasses break, although in this case, it's Trump breaking the glasses on purpose. Reading is for losers, nerd. So Republicans have made it clear over and over, they consider Trump the leader of their party, although there have been some suspiciously self-serving leaks to the media about two Trump family members in particular who are supposedly distancing themselves from the former president.
CNN learning that the two people closest to the former president during his time in office, Ivanka and his son-in-law, Jared Kushner, They actually have been distancing themselves from Trump and his constant grievances about the, quote, stolen election.
They do not want to be around, nor do they want to be in the orbit of this continued sort of not being able to move on, not being able to let go. And they've made a very calculated and thoughtful decision to back away and not spend as much time with the former president.
One thing I believe deeply in my heart is that Jared and Ivanka would break from Donald Trump after he lost the most powerful job in the world. You're my father, and I will stand by you no matter what. Hold on real quick. They're just about to call Pennsylvania. Okay, goodbye forever. Lose my number. Look, I can't say for certain that Jared and Ivanka are the ones behind this leak, but come on. And I just ask the media, please don't fall for it. If a friend of Jared calls you and says, I hear Jared's distancing himself from Trump, just say, Jared, I know that's you on the other end.
No, it's not.
Are you pretending to have a deep voice so I can't tell it's you?
No, this is Bert, strong man. Oh, I'm a friend of Jared's. Yeah, we go to the gym together and also to construction sites.
The modern GOP's core ideology revolves around his deep hostility to democracy and his devotion to Trumpism. They don't have much to say about actual policies, so instead they're ginning up culture war panics about everything from critical race theory to hamburgers to Dr. Seuss. And while some are beginning to face consequences, like Rudy, others are hoping they can quietly slink away from the mess they left behind. Anyway, we're about to go on a two-week hiatus, so all I can say for now is...
Thank you for listening. Stay tuned.
This has been A Closer Look. God's Love, We Deliver cooks and brings over 2 million meals a year to men, women, and children living with HIV, AIDS, cancer, and other serious illnesses, and they need your help now more than ever. If you're watching this online, you can hit the donate button. Stay safe. Get vaccinated. We love you.